So up until the year in, we were still kind of under that sort of optimistic approach of, hey, look, it's awesome. We got two developers. The money will come. It was only that year in when we saw we are allowing people to pay now, and yet they are not, that we found out about the problem, and we got more serious about talking to security people about what's holding them up. We would generally get positive feedback about it, but we uncovered two primary gaps, one around the breadth that I mentioned, the need to support more languages, and the other is specific capabilities that security teams need, that the buyer needs to be successful at rolling this out in the organization, around reporting, around some user administrations and others. So I think we were the conviction for of the sort of the developer first approach was still very strong throughout, because we from the beginning said we will crash and burn before we pivot out of this dev approach. The conviction about whether we can successfully do that and also get the security people to pay was a bit lower. Climbing out of that was a step-by-step process.